حمدا عدد خلقك ورضا نفسك وزنة عرشك ومداد كلماتك كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. الحمد لله على نعمة الإسلام وكفى بها نعمة. الحمد لله على نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة. الحمد لله الذي تفضل وأنعم، فاللهم اجعلنا من الحامدين الشاكرين الراضين المرتضين يا رب العالمين. آمين يا رب العالمين. نحمدك يا الله ونستغفرك ونتوب إليك ونتوكل عليك ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، الملك الحق المبين، القادر القدير المقتدر، العزيز الحكيم، الولي الوكيل المتعال، الغني المغني، الرزاق، مالك الملك وملك الملوك. سبحانك يا رب. وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلوات الله وسلامه عليك يا رسول الله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. أمين أمين يا رب العالمين. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يغفر لكم ذنوبكم، يصلح لكم أعمالكم، يغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. My dear brother in Islam, today, Jum'ah, the holiday of the Muslim, the Eid of the Muslim every week, Allah give it to us. What is the purpose of Jum'ah? The purpose of Jum'ah, to remember Allah, to glory Allah, to elevate Allah, to remember the purpose of this life and the hereafter. I just came from some trips, and I'm going again from some trips. And I gained one thing. One thing, it hit me so hard. When I was in a hotel, and I looked to some people in the lobby, and I remember two verses in Quran. What is the two verses from Quran? Verse 7 and 8, Surah Yunus. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said? إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا وَرَضُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَاطْمَأَنُّوا بِهَا وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِنَا غَافِلُونَ أُولَئِكَ مَأْوَاهُمْ النَّارُ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Four things I see it to us and all of us and the ummah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا. Allah said, those who do not want to meet me, who do not think about meeting me. This is the first one. What is the first condition? Those who do not think about meeting me and do not really want to meet me. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ لا يرجون لقاءنا ورضوا بالحياة الدنيا. And the second quality, and they are pleased with the dunya. They are pleased with the dunya. They're so pleased. They're pleased with their life. What ma'annu biha. And they're so comfort with it. والذين هم عن آياتنا غافلون. And those, they are in heedlessness with my sign. What is the sign of Allah? Getting older is a sign. Seeing a sick is a sign. Muslim fighting with each other is a sign. Hurricane, volcano, earthquake, you name it, is a sign. Diseases is a sign. Oppression is a sign. Being silent over oppression is a sign. What all this sign meaning? Is a sign to remind you you're next. That's it. You're next. And when I see all these verses, and after that what Allah said? أُولَئِكَ لَهُمْ جَهَنَّمْ لَهُمْ النَّارِ. Those will have torture in Jahannam. بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. With what they ordained. Believe me, I'm talking to you and my head is spinning. My head is spinning. Because I'm guilty like you. How many moments in a day we think about Jannah? How many moments in a day we think about Jahannam? How many moments we think about I'm going to meet Allah? And all of a sudden, one story, it hit me. But this story, it will fit all our condition. Leader, follower, husband, wife, kids, you name it. When Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu died. You know Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu? Umar radiallahu anhu, when they ask him, who's Abu Bakr? He said, Abu Bakr can say, إِذَا نَزَلَ نَفْعَ. Abu Bakr, like water, whatever it go, it benefit. There is a mu'min. This Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And we can talk about Abu Bakr. But in here I have a message, one message. But this message belongs to something very deep. Belong to verse 7 and 8 from Surah Yunus. When you go to the Gulf, even go to Saudi Arabia, go to Arabic country, go to Turkey, go to all over. What we have? Dunya! Even beard with Salah and Zakah and Hajj, dunya! The desire, dunya. The thinking, dunya. The thought, dunya. This, dunya. Worry, dunya. Dunya, worry, dunya. What's the purpose of Salah? What's the purpose of Hajj? With the birth of Zakah. And I will show you something more ugly than that. Very ugly. How many men divorce his wife 10,000 times? And he has the right only to divorce 2 or 3. Divorce, divorce, I divorce you. No, come, I divorce you. And nobody count. Nobody count. What it mean? You're living in haram. For years, and you have kids from haram. And you think, let it go. It's just anger. In the time of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he made constitution. He made tashriya when he was a khalifa. What is a tashriya? He make it obligatory, obligation for anyone divorce his wife to bring 2 witnesses. One from her family, one from her family. And the calculator start. By the way, no games. Today you find the man, he divorced his wife 10, 15, I don't remember. You don't remember? There's nothing, a toy to play with. This divorce. ثلاثاً هز لهن جد وجدهن جد. Rasulullah said 3. Is true. You laugh with them or true? Marriage. Divorce and raj'ah. Zawaj, talaq, and raj'ah. I cannot come in your living room and say, I won't marry your daughter. Hey, I'm laughing. I cannot do that. It's not allowed. I cannot tell my wife you divorce. Hey, I'm laughing. It's not allowed. It's count. I cannot say to my wife, I'm bringing you back, but I'm laughing. It's count. You have no right to laugh in 3. Zawaj. Marriage, divorce, and raja, to bring her back. You have no right to play with it. Today the ummah play with it, and nobody knows. And after that, you go to the Imam said, Mary, you know, patient, and people living in haram for 20 years. What is the point? Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, when he died, some people went to Aisha radiallahu anha, Ummul Mu'mineen, and they asked her, give us some quality about Abu Bakr we do not know. Tell us something unique about Abu Bakr. We want to learn about him. She said, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, we learned something from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What he learned? He learned to calculate his word, to digest his word before he say it, to investigate where is his word going. And we, the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we learn that. We learn that. What it means? I will explain to you. She said, one day, two men from Ahl al-Suffa, the poor people, very poor, they came to Abu Bakr and they said, Ya Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, and he was a Khalifa. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam promised us a piece of land. This for me and this for him. Listen carefully to the story, it will teach you a lot. As a leader, as a follower, as a scholar, as a this, as a husband, as a worker, you name it. Look, but this needs sincerity. It needs sincerity and need iman. Because if you have no iman and no sincerity, this will not benefit you. Really, it will not benefit. Today, we talk, but we do not digest what we're saying, where it's going. Look at the wisdom. This is the mu'min. Why? I will explain to you in the end. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, look what he did. He said to the two people, if anybody was present in the time of what Rasulullah SAW said, they said yes. Who was present? So and so was present. He said, okay, let's go to them. He go to them, he gathered all of them, and he said to the men, tell me again what you said. Look what he said. He did not want to break their heart. He did not want accusing them or right or wrong. Do you understand now the wisdom? He said to them, tell me what you tell me before. Repeat it. They repeat it. He said to the men, the eyewitness, do you witness about what they said? They said, yes. Beware witness to Allah and Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We was present when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam allocate this two land for them and give it to them. Right away, the two men scared. They said, Ya Abu Bakr, people die. We do not know who's living, who's dying. Write us a deed. Write us a formal deed with our land. By this way, we are A, prove our ownership. He wrote a deed for each one of them. And after he finished, he said, take this deed with the stamp of the Khalifa, Abu Bakr and his signature, and show it to Umar and tell me what happened. Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu. Look at the wisdom, go step by step, it's an unbelievable story. You can learn a lot from it. Now so you go both of them to Umar, and they said, Ya Umar, Abu Bakr sent us with this two deed, and he wanted to take a look. He looked at them, he tear it apart. He said, who he is? He's the Khalifa of the Mu'mineen, but he cannot spend the money of the Mu'mineen the way he wants. They ask him, he's a Khalifa. He said, okay, good, come with me. They go to Abu Bakr. Now imagine now Umar radiallahu anhu with the two letters from the Khalifa ripped apart. Ripped apart. A follower going to the Khalifa deny his command. And look how Abu Bakr, you know, handled it. Umar tell him, did you do that, Ya Abu Bakr? He said, yes. He said, who are you?
You are the Khalifa and you're not a custodian of the money of the Muslimin. You do whatever you want. Right away, Umar, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, Ya Umar, did I tell you before? You're the one you're supposed to be the Khalifa, not me. You have quality more than me. He didn't blame him. He didn't say nothing. He said, you have quality more than me. Meaning, he assumed in the front of him he made a mistake. He come on. He said, why you do that? He said, they have witness, Ya Umar. He said, who's the witness? So-and-so companion, so-and-so companion, so-and-so, big names. Umar is still just hurqa for the money. He's really worried about the money of the mu'mineen, the Muslimin. He takes the two men and go to the same eyewitness. He asks them, they answer back, he have proof. Now Umar come back. He apologize. And he concrete the two land for the two men. Now Abu Bakr read the two pieces of paper and give it to them. Now the two men ask him, Ya Abu Bakr, why you did what you did? Look at now the long vision of a leader. He said, I know the hurqa, the responsibility inside Umar about the money of the Muslimin. And if I did my decision alone, he can give you a hard time in the future. And you lose your right. I want concrete your right. Because if the companion heard about Umar, agree, finished. He did not have the ego. I'm the Khalifa. I have witness. And he argued. And after that, he explained. He said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he teach us to choose the word to unite, not divide. To choose the word to unite, not divide. To choose the word to bring goodness and back up evils. We choose the word to generate harmony among the Muslimin. Today, we are desperate to think what word I say, what I'm spreading, what I'm talking about, what I'm going to gain from that. This another thing. The mu'min, he think about the consequences of his word. He calculate it. He digest it. He think about the wisdom of his word for a generation. This is what Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu did. He didn't worry about his ego. He didn't worry about his status. He worried about the right of the two poor people. That's it. That's it, nothing else. But you know what does this need? Ikhlas. Ikhlas. Sincerity. The early people used to say, we used to go to companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask him fiqh question, 4 or 5 companion, big names. Oh brother, I have this question for you. Oh please, ask my brother. Every one of them denies the answer. And he said, let my brother answer. To the point the person repeated twice. And he said, please give me the answer. All of you knowing. He said, we the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would choose not to talk because talk is responsibility. And we used to choose other to talk in our behalf, much better. Today, you can talk to me and somebody says, no. What he said is wrong. I will tell you. And in 1 minute, 4 or 5 opinion with 4 or 5 decision was. And everybody running for a verdict, for a fatwa, for this, for that, for advice. Now ask yourself, if I'm a mu'min, I calculate my word. Do I divorce my wife every day? Do I divorce easy? Do I cheat myself and my wife and try to forget how many times I give her talqa? And when I go to Sheikh, I tell them I'm angry. Believe me, all of us need Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. When a man divorced his wife 3 times, he said, Allah tell you one, and you do it 3 times in one meeting? You know what he did, Umar? He gave him 100 lashes. Do you think if every man today he gets 100 lashes every time he makes talaq, you think he will make talaq again? Do we need beating like a donkey? Meaning we do not fear Allah. We do not respect Allah. We worry about the whip. Is this not this? Where is the iman? Where is the reality of iman and yaqeen and tawakkul on Allah? Where is the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Where is the belief? Is this my word? Will lead me to Jannah or lead me to Jahannam? Is what I'm saying, it will lead me to Jannah or Jahannam? I'm building palaces in Jannah or building palaces in Jahannam. What I'm doing? This is the quality of a mu'min. The quality of a mu'min digest, calculate every word before he say it and see where it's going. How many times today we make a mess over our community for nothing? How many of us spread a rumor for nothing? How many of us spreading word about each other for nothing? It become easy. And our woman backbiting for nothing. And you forget Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what he said. He said, I saw the majority of my ummah torture in the grave and not from a major sin. From the cleanness, not cleaning themselves, and bad tongue, backbiting. Do we worry about it? Do we care for it? Look at the condition. What about when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the one who's silent of the truth, he's a shaitan without no tongue. Shaitanun akhras. As-sakitu an al-haq, shaitanun akhras. And we are the only people getting zulm for 100 years. And nobody talked. Nobody talked. But we generate zulm among each other. No, our tongue should not generate zulm. Our tongue should regenerate harmony and goodness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the evil of our tongue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from the evil of our nafs. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the barakah and nur and qabool and hikmah in everything we say and we do. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decorate us with sincerity and ikhlas and truthfulness by his way we do it only for Allah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين أجمعين. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والتابعين إلى مدينة ما بعد. My dear brother Islam, the ummah is torn apart. Torn apart knowledge. Torn apart zulm. Torn apart rich and poor. Torn apart between each other. Torn apart in everything. Do you know why? Lack of iman. Lack of ikhlas. Lack of sidq. Because if we have ikhlas and sidq, we will never do that. We will have the tongue to unite, not to divide. We have the tongue lead us to Jannah, not to Jahannam. We have the tongue to generate goodness and protect us from evil. We have a tongue to generate harmony, not division. We have a tongue to generate peace, not dhulm. This is the tongue of a mu'min. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who have basira and nur and hikmah to realize what we say and what we say in it for, what we say in it for whom, for what purpose, with what intention. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من الحامدين الشاكرين.
اللهم اجعلنا من أهل الهدى والرضا واليقين. اللهم افتح علينا فتح العارفين، وكرمنا وأنت أكرم الأكرمين، وأعزنا وأنت العزيز الحكيم، وتولنا وأنت ولي النعم والقادر عليها يا رب العالمين. باسمك الأعظم ورضوانك الأكبر وسلطانك القديم وعرشك العظيم الكريم وبيتك العتيق، وبأسمائك الحسنى التي نعلمها ولا نعلمها، وباسمك الأعظم الأحب إليك الذي إذا دعيت به استجبت، اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم، إنك أنت الأعز الأكرم. اللهم عاملنا بما أنت أهله ولا تعاملنا بما نحن أهله، فأنت أهل الجود والكرم والإحسان. ارفع غضبك وسخطك عنا وعن أمة الحبيب المصطفى، ألف بيننا وبينك وبين حبيبك المصطفى، ألف بيننا وبين إخواننا المسلمين المؤمنين، ألف بيننا وبين قلوبنا في الخير يا رب العالمين. اجعلنا مفاتيحا للخير مغاليقا للشر، واجري الخير على أيدينا. اللهم يا بر يا رحيم، يا حنان يا منان، يا أكرم الأكرمين، يا أكرم الأكرمين ويا أرحم الراحمين، أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وعلي بحقك كلمة الحق والدين، وانصرنا على أنفسنا، وانصرنا على شياطيننا، وانصرنا على من بغى علينا، وانصرنا على من كادنا بسوء. يا الله أعزنا ولا تذلنا، كن معنا ولا تكن علينا، انصر بنا ولا تنصر علينا، امكر لنا ولا تمكر علينا، ارض عنا ولا تغضب علينا، افتح علينا يا رب العالمين، ارزقنا وانت خير الرازقين، اكرمنا وانت اكرم الاكرمين. يا عزيز يا عزيز، انت العزيز وانت المعز يا ربي، يا الهي يا مولانا، لا احد لنا الا انت، وانت الواحد الاحد الفرد الصمد القادر القدير المقتدر. افتح علينا فتح العارفين، واكرمنا وانت اكرم الاكرمين، واشف مرضى المسلمين، واشف مرضى المسلمين. اللهم ارحم موتى المسلمين، وفك الاسر عن الماسورين. ويا ربي يا الهي يا مولانا، هذا حال هذه الامه، حال امه حبيبك المصطفى يا رب العالمين. يا ربي لا احد لنا الا انت، اياك نعبد واياك نستعين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. يا جبار يا قوي يا متين يا الله يا الله يا الله، تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا مولانا إنك أنت أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين برحمتك يا رحمة. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعدكم لعلكم تذكرون، اذكروا الله يذكركم، وأقم الصلاة.